Okay, class. Okay, sekarang kita tengok how to perform a computation involving combined operation integers. Okay, and follow the order of the operation below. Okay, maksud dia sekarang kita nak tengok pengiraan yang berkaitan dengan gabungan operasi matematik. Okay, so dalam operasi matematik mungkin kita ada bracket, darab atau bahagi ataupun addition ataupun subtract ni kan. Okey, ataupun you kena ingat ni lah formula BODMAS eh. BODMAS. Okey, so B stand for bracket, O ni stand for order lah. Order ni kuasa eh. Order. D is deviation, M is multiplication, A is addition and S is for subtract. So kalau you lupa kena ingat ni BODMAS punya order lah. So BODMAS punya order untuk kita solve combination operation of integers. Okay, so kita tengok example 1 eh. Practice 1.2. Okay, kita tengok example 1 A eh. Kita tengok A. So kita ada negative 9. Okay, times. Okay, ada bracket negative 4 plus 6. So kalau kita follow dia punya order BODMAS tadi kan, BODMAS. Okay, we must solve in bracket first kan. Okay, so we solve in the bracket first. So negative 4 plus 6 equals 2 kan. Okay, 2. Okay, and then yang dekat luar bracket ni kita just turunkan je, just carry forward negative 9 times 2. So kita akan dapat negative 9 times 2 is equal negative 18. Okay, then kita tengok example, we try example D eh, this one D eh. Okay, D, dia ada operation deviation eh, bahagi ni. Okay, so negative 14 plus negative 22, so divide negative 23 minus negative 35, so we will get, okay, so positive number, sorry, negative plus positive eh. So we'll get negative, we get 14 minus 22 divided by plus negative number kita akan dapat, sorry, minus negative number kita akan dapat plus kan, tambah kan, negative 23 tambah dengan 35. So kita akan dapat ni berapa, negative, 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 jadi negative, negative 36 divided by, okay, negative berapa ni, 35 23, kita kat calculator lah kalau malas nak ni kan. Okay, negative 23 plus, okay, plus 35, okay, 12, okay. Okay, and then kita akan dapat apa? So negative 36 dibuat by 12. So kita akan dapat negative 3. Okay. Okay, class. And then kita refer ataupun try to solve problem self-practice 1.2e eh. This one is solving problem eh. Okay, so for example, a shop made a profit of 18,800 in the first year. Okay, so first year kita buat lah. First year kita ada profit eh. Profit RM 16,800. So this one profit means positive eh. Okay, and then and incurred a loss. Loss ni that mean dia rugi lah. Okay, 6,500 for each year for next two consecutive years. Maksudnya dalam 2 tahun berturut-turut dia loss. Okay, so second year, so third year pun dia loss lah. Loss means dia negatif lah. Negatif RM 6500 and 6500. And then in the fourth year, the loss incurred was twice the loss incurred in the second year. Mana second year? Okay, so dia 6500, maksudnya the fourth dia dua kali eh? Twice dua kali eh. So dua kali that's mean 2 times negative RM 6500. So equal berapa ni? So negative RM 13,000 lah. Okay, and then how much the profit or loss of the shop at the 4 years? Maksud berapakah keuntungan ataupun kerugian untuk keempat-empat tahun ni lah. Untuk keempat tahun ni. Okay, so okay, just tambah je lah. Okay, so kita buat macam ni lah. So the profit lah, profit ataupun loss lah eh. RM 1 ni first year. Okay, plus negatif RM 6500. Okay, plus negatif RM 6500. And then plus negatif RM 13,000. Okay. Okay, so berapa dapat ni? Tambah semula eh. Okay, so jadinya RM 16,800 tolak RM 6,500 minus RM 6,500. So plus negatif dia negatif tolak eh. Plus RM 13,000. So berapa total? Tekan jalan kalkulator eh. Kita dah ada kemudahan kalkulator. 16,800 tolak dengan 6,500 tolak 6,500 tolak dengan 13,000. Okay, so maksudnya negatif RM 9,200. So negatif means dia loss lah. Loss RM 9,200.